FIGU Special Bulletin 62, July 2011. Important note by the translator J.B.S. This statement, theories, aliens and conspiracies. Or statement to the exopolitics and other fallacious teachings related groupings, from FIGU was written by a member of the Czech FIGU and it is an answer to an article, or analysis, written by an authoress from the Czech Republic whose name is Dana Rasinova. Dana Rasinova is a former member of FIGU who was expelled from FIGU. Dana Rasinova nowadays is an active member of the Exopolitics in the Czech Republic. Dana Rasinova's article against the Plejaden, against Billy Meyer, and against the mission is titled, The Analyze Why Meyer's Plejadians Lie and Think Part I and Part 2. Exopolitics Czech Republic, author Dana Rasinova. Dana Rasinova's article can be found in English language online at the website of the Exopolitics Czech Republic. The link to it, for obvious reasons, is not given here. Theories, aliens and conspiracies. Or statement to the exopolitics and other fallacious teachings related groupings. Author Andriy Tepanovsky, Chechnya FIGU Special Bulletin No. 62 pages 13,14. 15,16 and 17th issue, July 2011 Wassermann Zeit Verlag / Billy Edward Albert Meyer. Introduction. We, members of the FIGU study group of the Czech Republic as well as the members of all FIGU groups worldwide, are oriented towards the practice of the own life. The success in the development of our own lives, the acquisition of good, correct and useful behavior, as well as the creation of beneficial and liberating values of life are always the center of our efforts. We find nothing so important than to open our own eyes, in order to clearly see what is true and real. And we find nothing so important than to learn to understand better our own consciousness, to develop it, to purify it, to free it from falsehoods and to be useful through really elaborated abilities efficiently and successfully. The teaching of the Free Community of Interests for Border and Spiritual Sciences and Ufological Studies, referred to as FIGU abbreviated, is not a book, but is life itself and its laws and procedures. Hence all the translations on our website serve to every human being as an introduction to his her everyday thinking, feelings and behavior, nothing more and nothing less. If, however, this fact is misunderstood and is understood as a bare theory, one makes a fundamental mistake in logic and misjudges the value of life, the spiritual teaching of Billy Edward Albert Meyer and also the work of FIGU. Theories. Especially in the present time, it is necessary to emphasize again and again that theory means only if and buts, but not the reality. Theory is deceptive, full of assumptions, opinions, personal convictions, egoism, deception and fallacies. Theories, that are thick volumes, articles, pictures, TV programs and films that create delusions in the minds of the ignorant and unenlightened people in which then they irretrievably lose themselves and are no longer able to distinguish between reality, truth and untruthfulness, value and unvalue. To them, everything seems to be the same or similar because they indulge themselves in absolutely life-distant and unrealistic ways of thinking, which they allow to enslave them in the consciousness and they do not get further. To it, is suitable a paragraph by Billy Edward Albert Meyer, which he wrote already in 1958, in his letter Prophecies and Predictions, because they are already creating phantasmagoria, through movies and television, as well as later through a worldwide netting of computers and electronics, through which they deceive themselves and see things that do not exist, and are only visually determined for the eye. Subsequently their sense for reality disappears and they can no longer distinguish between reality and fiction, whereby they lose themselves more and more in the labyrinth of life, while those who produce phantasms commercially as well as religious and sectarian phantasms, have an easy game with the people of faith, who they deceive in every possible manner and make them into humble beings, like cringing dogs. The sum of all wrong assumptions, opinions, ideas, fantasies, deceptions and mistakes with which the human being occupied himself intellectually and which can become his personal conviction, his belief and his property quite soon, find an appropriate expression in the concept phantasmagory. Phantasmagoria is defined as hallucination or delusion in the Duden Dictionary and describes an artificial, consciousness-related created illusory world, which associates itself very strongly with one's own ego and forms a solid counterblock to the reality and its truth. Through the phantasmagoria, to which he adheres, the human being in his entire lifetime often does not get further and lives stubbornly beyond the reality with what related with the erroneous and false teaching, he influences also the environment accordingly. He brings forth with him his apparent theory and knowledge opinions, arguments and behavior patterns completely far from the reality and from life which he won through books, television and in the internet, that he with persuasiveness, resourcefulness and absolute naturalness implies as true and correct and is able to defend it ad nauseam. He often uses for his argumentations everything of which he can take hold and in this way he creates artificial and misleading connections between the facts known to him. On account of his crazy views his consciousness works and processes everything in such a way that it can be exploited for the benefit of his personal struggle. Through that he misjudges the facts, abuses his own consciousness and makes the reality and its truth into a personal egoistic farce. A sounding and apparent good convincing argumentation chain or thought construction is still for a long time no truth, but mostly just only bare, completely valueless theory. Unfortunately, there are many people who think wrongly in this regard, but as a rule, they do not notice it, because they do not want it profoundly which constantly points to their wrong action, and because they already automatically unconsciously, partly consciously or consciously reject and suppress the creative impulses. False teachings. The motivation for this treatise was a 15 pages article by the name of The Analyze Why Myers Pleiadians Lie and Faint. That was written by a member of the Czech Exopolitics and was published for dissemination in the internet note from the editors of FIGU Bulletin quite obviously as an act of revenge due to the expulsion of the authoress from the FIGU. The authoress wanted to draw the attention of the FIGU members and of other interested parties to the fact that the Pleiaron in certain interests consciously lie, maneuver or deny. Specifically that is supposed to refer to specific details about ufology, politics and the military on our Earth. Thus, the Pleiaron therefore supposedly consciously play down, circumscribe or even deny the facts about the most different real contactees, alien races and conspiracies etc. on the Earth. The reason for this the authoress sees in various hypotheses or theories, such as, that the Pleiaron want to draw all the attention of the FIGU members to themselves, to the spiritual teaching, as well as to the carrying out and maintenance of the mission, that FIGU members, by their ignorance, should be protected against negative influences, that many real things about the aliens and the conspiracies are too dangerous or would endanger the authority of the Pleiaron on the Earth, that the people in general should be appeased etc. In principle the authoress points out that the members of FIGU or those parties interested in FIGU are too one-sided and are too faithful about the whole complexity of the world events to be able to understand, in regard to the secret machinations, the contacts and the aliens etc. because they would deliberately be misled precisely by the Pleiaron and Billy. In her article she lists 20 specific points with which she cannot explain herself consistently. This is why she attempts to impose it with the supposed contradictions in the Pleiadian/Pleiaron contact reports as well as in the explanations of Billy and Patar, with which she quotes innumerable alternative sources and highlights them as a counterweight for the information of the Pleiaron, Billy and the FIGU. The poor reader, unprepared and unenlightened that comes into contact with her article can make, more or less, the following picture about the today's world events or the reality, if the described hair-raising, misleading and far from the truth absurdities in the analyzed article are taken, clueless and unclarified, as bare truth on earth. There are currently countless real contactees not referring to the visual or impulse contactees, where their number is constantly growing. The very dangerous draconians or reptilians are also active on the Earth and form an imperial alliance. Also the very dangerous little greys are at the work here and made a pact particularly with the US government, and this probably under the leadership of the reptilians and or draconians. The Roswell film is real and represents a little grey. On the planet Earth there are great quantities of kidnappings of the civil population through different extraterrestrial civilizations, probably especially through the little greys. In addition, they are military kidnappings through MILAB. The president of the US Eisenhower actually met aliens at that time. Our governments are working predominantly with the negative aliens, including reptilians, and are partially controlled by them. There are very many subterranean bases in most different countries of the world, in which, for example, a secret cooperation with various extraterrestrial races takes place. It is most probably that we are in the middle of a conflict between at least two extraterrestrial combat groups, the Peace Fight Troops of the Galactic Federation and the Pirate Forces of the Imperial Alliance. The Pirate Forces, embodied by the Draconians, the Little Greys, the Earthly Reptilians, the Military-Industrial Extraterrestrial Complex Miek and the Illuminati, and further supposedly by the Freemasons, Black Magicians, Zionists, Bilderbergers, etc., strive for the total control of the earthly humanity, for example, through a sophisticated network of monitoring and influencing technology satellites, transmitters, HARP, supervisioning of the internet network and the computer, etc., that through the installation of microchips under the skin every ordinary citizen is supposed to be degraded. Furthermore, the Draconians, Reptilians and Little Greys want to use the planet Earth as a source of food, since they mainly like to consume the human flesh. In addition, they use the earthly flora, the fauna and the humankind as sources of genetic material for experiments and for the creation of hybrid races. Under these circumstances, they want to transport the earthly humans as slaves to other planets. However, they are also positive extraterrestrials, who are ready to evacuate the earthy humans. They are many people of the Earth that are capable of telepathy and channelings. Chemtrails are real. The Plearen have lied once concerning their place of origin. Until 1995 they spoke of the Pleiades, but after that as the Plearen. Consequently they can use such lies and tactics at any time, and the faithful FIGU members buy it from them thoughtlessly. These and further absurdities are named in the mentioned article, as it were as an alternative or as a counterbalance to the information of the Plearen and Billy, with what the authoress says in the introduction, that she does not have to be absolutely right with all the allegations, but that she would at least stimulate the reflection. However, only one single concept fits to the whole nonsense phantasmagoria. Certainly, not all the Exopolitics initiatives in the whole world. For further detailed information on the Exopolitics, cedar.wikipedia.org web link. Indulge in such a crass nonsense like the Czech, however, this still does not mean in any way that these do a clarification according to the truth. They in reality do it only partially, with what, however, they succumb seriously to the purely esoteric, ufological and religious sectarian false teachings, and they let themselves be deceived by the numerous false prophets, clairvoyants, contactees, book authors and self-appointed experts, and they adhere to the most different realities, fantasies or even hallucinations and become a slave to them. Therefore, with the worldwide operating Exopolitics, extreme caution is necessary because it very often drifts into unreal pathways and represents and disseminates fatal confusion and false teachings. At the same time, it is to be emphasized that the FIGU does not criticizes the good of this or that grouping, but criticizes and rejects solely the wrong and false teachings related. Therefore we, the members of the FIGU Studien and FIGU Landesgruppen, expressly distance ourselves of every exopolitics nonsense or of any other kind of false teaching related, as well as of these or similar groupings, regardless of whether they are on ufology, false contactees, schindlers, esotericism, religious sectarianism, or are aligned with abstruse and paranoid conspiracy theories. We reject strictly the whole nonsense spread by these groups and based on mere unrealistic theories and assumptions, since on one hand, it has no relation with the FIGU and the reality, and on the other hand, it does not hold any elucidation related to real truth in itself, but only more confusion, misleading, stultification, smoke and mirrors. Reality. Reality and its truth are the effective reality of creation and its natural laws. These are independent of all books, films, religious and sectarian statements, opinions, theories, ideas, convictions, wishes, belief forms, conceits and false teachings of the humans. The creation itself exists as universal consciousness, as spiritual energy, and can never be seen, heard, learned or experienced by the human being. Only its activity can be seen, heard, learned and be experienced, in the form of the entire universe and everything that exists in it, breathes, creeps and flies. The only way to be able to fathom, to penetrate the creative reality is neutrality, impartiality, healthy critical faculties, clarity in thinking, solid motivation, hard reality-based thoughts and feelings, as well as bodywork and a lifelong honest striving for the higher things. Surfing on the internet and reading imbecilic books and articles, and so on, causes only doubt, uncertainty and confusion, which can lead to the complete loss of reality. In this way, the human being fills his consciousness with wrong and perverted data, which begin to work in it and are able to thoroughly dominate it. Through that he becomes blind and weak and incapable to recognize the reality and its truth. Exactly on that is based, however, the teaching of truth, the teaching of spirit, the teaching of life of Billy Edward Albert Meyer, that contains only absolute effective laws, recommendations and guidelines of life, the evolution and the creative and natural truth, that every human being can follow in his real and everyday life successfully, when he is encouraged and enabled for this purpose. The explanations of the Pleiaren and Billies with regard to the extraterrestrial presence on the Earth, as well as concerning the most different conspiracies, are also no theory, but pure determination of facts and thus truth. They correspond to the best possible knowledge which is available to us on this planet today, even when persons who are misguided and affected by paranoid conspiratorial theories and other absurdities and false teachings claim the opposite. The ufological and other reality facts and connections in the Pleiadian/Pleiaren contact reports and various other FIGU writings are anything but easily and quickly understood and compiled, because they require an immense intellectual work, as well as a laborious and a reality-related evolution of one's own thoughts, feelings, actions and deeds. The real truth does not fall into nobody's lap, as everybody knows, and it must be gained in the hard way. If one, however, shies away from the serious efforts, one remains on the old hapless pathways, and through that scorns and mocks the own evolution, one will, in his thoughts and feelings, only run past the reality, because these thoughts and feelings are too weak, too slow and too uneducated to be able to understand them consciously. The whole case Billy Meyer is, thereupon, oriented, that the human being becomes thinking by himself, that is independently and powerfully thinking. Because of that, the Pleiarens do not land on our garden, but they ask to us to recognize and to develop the reality, as well as, above all, to us to think by ourselves thoroughly about everything in all respects. Only if we do that, we enable ourselves to recognize, to acquire, and to register the real meaning of the spiritual teaching, the mission, the contact reports and all other reality facts as knowledge. Sooner or later, we ourselves understand why the Pleiaren and Billy act one way or another, and we recognize the complete correctness and logic that is behind it. Only then we really understand that the Pleiaren must neither lie nor maneuver, because regarding this they are not like the human beings of the Earth, but are enormously much higher in their knowledge, their wisdom and their love, in their peace and their freedom and harmony. They bring to us through their mediator and prophet Billy Edward Albert Meyer an enormously high and intensive knowledge in all areas of life, that it makes everything else in this world pale into insignificance, more especially, However, those that are the erroneous religions and sects, as well as the far-fetched assumptions that on the Earth there are still other countless real contactees, alien races, extraterrestrials and the governments and conspiracies etc., all this humbug is irrelevant and gives a terrible evidence of how the human beings of the Earth are still immature, simple-minded, unreasonable, lacking of understanding and delusional believers. Never ever the ufologic, esoteric and exopolitic circles, as well as the other false teachings related groupings, will admit the truth and the fact and accept that Billy Edward Albert Meyer is the only real genuine contactee with the extraterrestrials, the Pleiaden, on the Earth, unless they themselves go to one another, throw all false teachings overboard and have a good and honestly look at the reality and its truth. Whether they, however, will ever become capable for this purpose and will also do it, that one must really wonder, when considering all the stupidity and absurdities that through the Analyze article, together with a lot of other nonsense of the conspiracy theoreticians, wiseacres, alleged contactees, shindlers, esoterics, occultists and sectarian and so forth, was thrown as sensationalist fodder to the humanity of the Earth. That with it also is widespread blazing fear and terror, or at least a large uncertainty among many people who read all the absurdities and insane craziness and absorb it into themselves, that it is completely all the same to all those that act irresponsibly in the mentioned framework and also approve it as an acceptable consequence, regardless that people, because of it, lose their heads, doubt their mental sanity, or even kill themselves. For that already is enough, only the absurd and alienated from the reality and truth Analyze article. The end.